أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألم نشرح لك صدرك
Did we not expand for you, O Muhammad, your breast?
فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألم نشرح لك صدرك Have we not expanded or opened up for you your chest?
وَوَضَعْنَا عَنْكَ وِزْرَكَ
And we removed from you your burden.
وَوَضَعْنَا عَنْكَ وِزْرَكَ And we removed from you that heavy burden.
الَّذِي أَنْقَضَ ظَهْرَكَ
Which had weighed upon your back.
الَّذِي أَنْقَضَ ظَهْرَكَ Which was nearly breaking your back.
وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ
And raised high for you your repute.
وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ And we have exalted for you your renown and fame.
فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا
For indeed, with hardship will be ease.
إِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا
Indeed, with hardship will be ease.
فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا إِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا So, always, along with hardship is ease. And again, surely, along with hardship is ease.
فَإِذَا فَرَغْتَ فَانْصَبْ
So when you have finished your duties, then stand up for worship.
فَإِذَا فَرَغْتَ فَانْصَبْ So when you have accomplished your task, the mission assigned to you, فَانْصَبْ Then exert yourself fully.
وَإِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ فَارْغَبْ
And to your Lord direct your longing.
وَإِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ فَارْغَبْ And let your, towards your Lord be your entire quest. Now, this is known that this is from among the very early Makki surahs. And the conditions for the Prophet and the companions of the Prophet were very hard. They had to struggle hard at that time. Where was the ease? Had this surah been revealed in Medina, it would have meant something else. Those hard times are gone. Now, the things are very easy for you, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. But no, very early Makkah surahs. So what does it mean? What was ease to him? What was the meaning of the expanding of his chest? What was the meaning that he was relieved of the burden that was nearly going to break his back? Now let me quote here. But I am giving you, and I agree with, that is from Qazi Sanaullah Panipati Rahmatullahi Alayh, one of the mystic Mufassirin of Indian subcontinent of the last century. He says, actually, for a prophet, or a saint, the most lovable thing is that he should keep solely, exclusively attentive to his Lord. Why to discharge the duties as a messenger you have to go out? You have to talk to the people. You want to keep yourself engaged in meditation. With your Lord. Go on in your lonely place, praying to Him, talking to Him, conversing with Him. Let your soul have a direct communication with your Lord. This is the most enjoyable thing that a human being can ever imagine. But now, the command is go. Izabila Fir'auna innahu taga. Go to Fir'aun. He has transgressed. now you have to face. But the biggest pain that he is having is that that condition which he had when he was talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the Mount of Tur, how pleasant it was. So Allama Iqbal has quoted Shaykh Abdul Qaddus of Gango in his lectures. Once he said, Muhammad Arabi Balai Asma Raft to Baz Ahmad. Bukhuda agar man raftame, baz na amdame. Muhammad of Arabia went to the highest heaven and then came back. By God, if I had reached there, I would never have come back. So this is the difference between the mystic experience and the prophetic experience. A mystic, a Sufi, wants to keep himself with his Lord. No interference. This is the tendency which led to that monasticism. This was, you know, unbalanced attitude that led to monasticism. Why to marry? Have all these, you know, problems. 101 problems for you if you marry. You have a family, now you have to feed them, care for them. Now the child is sick, and now you have to get him admitted to the school, and so on and so forth. Now you can't have that, you know, that sukoon, tranquility of your mind. Baithe rahe tasavvur jana kiye hue. Keep sitting and have the thought of Allah in your mind and nothing else. So that was the pain actually which Muhammad was having sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. While he was asked to go out, preach to the people. We are looking only to the outside pain that he was getting when some said, oh, you have gone crazy, oh, you are a poet, oh, you are a sorcerer or a magician. This was also hurting him. وَلَقَدْ نَعْلَمُ أَنَّكَ يَزِيقُ صَدْرُكَ بِمَا يَقُولُونَ. But that is not mentioned here. That, you know, his difficulties were going to more and more multiply in the coming years. But أَلَمْ نَشْرَحْ لَكَ صَدْرَكَ. That was painful to him was his occupation with this propagation of religion and not keeping himself alone in the loneliness. Plotinus has said very beautiful verse. Flight of the alone to the alone. Within us we have something which is alone, and that is our Ruh. Ruh is not son of someone and daughter of someone and brother of someone. Ruh has no connection with anybody here in this world. It's all alone. Whatever it is by itself. So when one is sitting and contemplating and meditating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is the flight of the alone. The Ruh within me and you now comes out, goes up, 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 up. Flight of the alone to the alone. Qul huwallahu ahad. He is the alone. أَلَمْ نَشْرَحْ لَكَ صَدْرَكَ وَضَعْنَا عَنْكَ وِزْرَكَ الَّذِي أَنْقَضَ ظَهْرَكَ وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. As time progressed, Muhammad came to know how much it is delightful for you when even a single person accepts Islam and you feel, now this brother of mine is saved from the fire of hell. This is another delight. This delight now takes the place of that delight. The Sufia used three terms for suluk. There is sair ilallah, one is going nearer, nearer, nearer to Allah. Then sair fillah, now contemplating and meditating the person or the attributes of Allah. This is that position from which if you are asked to go away, then you feel pain. You feel hurt. But the third stage is sair anillah ilallah. Now you are going away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to go down the Mount of Noor, where Muhammad received his first revelation in the cave of Hira, Jabal al-Noor. And Musa had to come down from Kohetur, the Mount of Tur. Izhab ila Fir'aun innahu tagha. But that's here, alillah illallah. But this is for Allah. So that more and more of His creatures, they are saved from the fire of hell. They turn towards Allah. This is the biggest delight, biggest delight, biggest delight. But you come to it, to realize it, but you have to take some time for that. This yusra has now come to you, but you had to pass that through that also, that difficulty. You had to cross that, but now you feel. The Prophet said to Ali, Ya Ali, لا يهدي الله بك رجلا واحدا خير لك من حمر النعم. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes even a single human being towards the right path because of you, it is much more precious than so many red camels. That was the biggest, you know, wealth for the Arabs. Rajulan wahidan. Guidance will be given by Allah, but you have become instrumental in it. أَنْ يَهْدِيَ اللَّهُ بِكَ. If Allah guides even one human being through you, through your effort, through your da'wah, خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنْ حُمْرِ النَّعَمُ. Red-colored camels, a host of them, this is more precious than that. Now فَإِذَا فَرَغْتَ. This is for the future. When that time comes, يَا الْحَقُّ وَزَحَقَ الْبَاطِلِ. When that time comes, then you'll be free. Then you attach yourself with us absolutely. فَإِذَا فَرَغْتَ فَانْصَبْ وَإِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ فَارْغَبْ. And this is, you know, historically speaking, in the seerah, the sermon that Muhammad gave sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one evening before he died. Came out from his hujra. And you know, the salah prayer was in progress. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was leading the prayer. When he felt that the Prophet has come out, he tried to get back so that he comes forward to lead the prayer. But he said, no, no, you continue. Then he sat by his side. Now, sitting in that sitting posture, he was the Imam of Abu Bakr, and Abu Bakr was the Imam for the rest of the congregation. That way that prayer was completed. Then he gave the sermon. Allah has given an option to a servant of His. If he likes this world, he can choose it. If he likes the other, he can choose it. And the servant has chosen the other one. Abu Bakr wept. And some of the people said, look to this old man. Why is he weeping? But Abu Bakr has understood that the Prophet has decided to go now. Because to every messenger, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives this option. Now from our side, you are free. You have done your duty. If you want to come back, okay. If you want to still stay in the world, okay. We shall grant you further lease. And that is why the last words on the tongue of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam at the time of death, Allahumma fir rafiqil a'la. Now I choose rafiqul a'la, that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I give up this world.